had of late at the striker position. So has that played into the decision tonight for FC Dallas head coach Shelus Hyman? This is Brad Davis looking for the speedster Dominic Odura. How will George John handle that? There are four of those on the Houston Dynamo roster. Richard Mulrooney to the benefit of the Dynamos. Davis takes a free kick. Good header away by George John. Max McCarty will close him down. Mulrooney looking over the head of George John. Going for just a third year man who's come over from Real Salt Lake.
He's definitely been inconsistent at times. And
for exactly that, isn't he, Steve?
Yeah, I mean, really good player. Very comfortable over the
ball.
Three
people surround the ball. So important, especially on the road.
Quick throw in taken. George John holding up the hard-working Latu. EPL Park. Long ball cleared by the Union defense. Moreno looking to hold it up. He's in a foot race with George John. John wins out. The left defender, who's a former teammate of Ugo Hemelus. Harvey into Latu. Stood up nicely by George John. Pull the ball back. He finds Hernandez, composed midfielder. George John will now clear things. Jeff Cunningham, has he timed his run well? Chris Seitz way out.
This is usually a very, very good opportunity.
There it is, back post! So his return to the defensive holding position has been good for the Union. This is Mwanga, but intercepted nicely by George John.
Maple put it into play. Not a bad idea. That needed to be higher. McBride was there. Flag stays down. Here's the cross. Curls back post and beyond. Miyako. Conde. Oh, George John and he crunch each other. But I think he'll play tonight.
That's tough getting that news.
Remember, Dallas has won all four games played on this field. They've got a huge edge.
Well, the good part about bringing on Heath Pierce is he can attack as well. So you have someone that has the defensive capabilities but can also get forward and be dangerous. So the two of them will really lock this side down.
Yeah, Pierce playing as a left-sided midfielder. There he is right now on the ball. Roll on the run, left side against Breck Shea. Cross comes in. Clear it out several minutes ago. George John cuts that off. Zach Roy. From Pierce, likes the left foot better.
That's too cute. You're not going to get one twos at the top of the box like that. Someone has to have a crack.
Spindola, looking for the speed of Finley. John has the position. Finley still giving chase. Finding plenty of space on this far side. Milton Rodriguez is on Borchers. The center defender does well to head the ball away. George John breaking up yet another play in the defense.
Bobby, I've talked a little bit about Breck Shea's first touch, but I've got to give him nothing but positives in terms of his commitment to try to get into the box and try to create things.
Quick strike. Counterattack now. Morales into Finley. It's a foot race. John and Finley. George John wins out. Good, solid defending again. Russell. Or Alave, rather, charging through midfield now. Center defender starting the counter. George John is there. Such a key figure in the center of defense for this Dallas back line. Rodriguez is hooked up with Breck Shea. He's in alone. The left foot is Shea.
If the preseason players get it, it's a lot more relaxed, a lot more comfortable. But
it's 21 and 17 games looking for their first as it's played short to Avila. Has the option to Pearson. He'll lump one in and totally unmarked. FC Dallas are level. It's George John, the big central defender, to bring the MLSers back on parity.
Again, it loops up at that far post. It's all about the delivery. He's been a bright spark as well. And he has to concentrate. It's Mike on actually. It gets caught ball watching. Look at him here. He's got no idea where the player is. It's too late. Goalkeeper can't come.
An injection of young pace.
They do have a difficult time, as we see in the World Cup, but make good decisions, sensible decisions.
Cambiasso tried to link up with Sammy Eto'o to no avail.
And finally out by left back, Benitez, recovered by Tony Beltran, has Espíndola to his left. Espíndola against Chavez, first time service into the box. Well, a positive scoreline in favor for FC Dallas when scoring the first goal. 12-1-6. You see at the bottom, at the very top of your screen, underneath our score here, the 1-0 lead for FC Dallas. It's 3-1 in favor after that 2-1 win last week at Pizza Hut Park. Espíndola finding space once again on that left flank. Service into the box. George John settles with his chest, and that allows Jackson to clear.
Fantastic anticipation there from John.
Espíndola elects to look for Andy Williams. He had both Kyle Beckerman and Robbie Russell down the right-hand side. Grabovoy, Saborío up over the top looking for Espíndola. Good positioning once again from George John. Combination play with Will Johnson. Benitez closing down Paulo Jr. Looking to get to the byline. Cross gets inside. And once again, George John, great position. 4 minutes of extra time added by our fourth official, Jair Marufo. Switch to the left-hand side. Beltran, big first touch as Will Johnson will take it off his feet. Cuts back inside. Beltran onside. Gets his head up. Closed down by Lloyd. Beltran, once again, the positioning of George John. Perfect placement.
So difficult to get that creativity to break down that block. You see time and time again, they're trying.
Andy Williams now. Good first touch. Williams from distance. Hartman. Didn't know much about it, got enough. Williams back in the box. George John touched up and over.
Throughout the league, but just because the media maybe doesn't pick up on it, and that's the motivation that you want.
It's a great ball to Donovan. The return, headed away.
Well, it was an excellent defensive header by the veteran U.S. international, Eddie Lewis.
Beckham long for Buttle. George John is there by himself. Does well, and then Buttle is holding on to him. And the foul was called. That's tough to do. One-on-one after that long ball from Beckham, defending Buck. 54th minute. Ferreira with the lone goal of this game. Ferreira strikes it near post. Comes all the way out off a deflection. Chavez mishits. Chavez with a second go at it. Ihemelu still up there from the corner. Nice ball. Brick Shea is in. Shea the cross and a goal for George John. FC Dallas has a 2-0 lead.
And here again, the header comes out. It's still not cleared out. Chavez does an excellent job to keep this back in. You see Ihemelu, the ball right down. Brick Shea first touch forward. Very well done. And the ball right across through the legs of Omar Gonzalez. You see this on the run.
On the turn, Frank reveals it for Burchill. Wide again for Beckham. This time, a left-footed cross inside. It comes out to Burchill. He came around. It was deflected. He'll drive it into the box. Looking for Buttle. George John won that. We're talking, everybody's talking more about FC Dallas, and for good reason. Kazumba. That's George John winning another one.
Is quick, but not quite that quick to latch onto that one. Lorentovic with the important interception. A real tenacious stuff from him in the middle of the pitch there. Van Smith. Now here's Connor Casey.
George John did such a good job of shutting down and closing Edson Buttle. He didn't give him a lot of space. We know how lethal Edson Buttle has been all season long for LA.
Wallace with some good play. Smith's got a bit of grass to work with here. It's well cut out by George John. George John. Defender very impressive in that game against Galaxy last week. Now Cunningham. It's McCarty again. Thought about the shot. Feeds Cunningham. Great ball in. Again, Connor Casey. He's having a very good game. He's making a nuisance of himself.
It wasn't even really, it was just an awkward challenger that led to that foul.
Could we be headed for overtime here, I wonder? All the time, but in a tight game, sometimes it can just be a bit of luck, and that's what it was, really. Good work by Kanji, but you couldn't really...
No, you can never, ever see that coming in. But again, like you said, it's a bit of luck, but he made his own luck. It's an intense cup final.
Lorentovic's header wasn't a good one. Bouncing around dangerously, and then George John splendidly denied by Pickens.
Now, but here's a shot
Avila tries to get on the end of it, and there's George John down low. He gets behind it. Great save, because that has been screened by a defender. Excellent save by Matt Pickens. Very well done.
Oh, the 18-year-old made a nice move. The cross, one flick. There's his second over the bar. George John with that last opportunity.
You know that as an attacking player, you like to get as many touches as possible. And against Colorado being so good in the center of the park, he may drift out wide to find that ball more often than not.
George John wins it. Back to Breck Shea. Ferreira's looking his way. Never reached him. Cleared out. Waiting for the single. Corner kick again. Colorado looking for a different look here by bringing in Ameriquois. Lorentowicz lost it there. Works it against Lorentowicz. The cross, George John, right at Pickens.
It's Terry Dunfield, the native of Vancouver, 29 years old, looking long. George John defending the Frenchman, Eric Ostley. That's a matchup to keep an eye on today, Steve. Former Dallas man, Blake Wagner. Ostley, good touch, trying to get around John just moments afterwards.
It's a major theme of this first half, is this back four of FC Dallas. Although Ugo and George John have been consistent in the middle of the park, it's the changes. Jair Benitez coming in, but also Jackson coming in.
Not only in the last two games, but all of last season and since his arrival in a Dallas jersey. But for the moment, it doesn't matter. And the man that's gotten on the end of a corner kick is George John. He's pulled things level for FC Dallas.
Good ball by Chavez. Flicked on by Jackson. And George John doing a tremendous job getting on the end of this one, putting his FC Dallas team. Nothing Jay Nolley could do about that. And Jackson just flicking it on. George John being in the right place at the right time. And FC Dallas tying this game up. What a phenomenal goal by George John in the 53rd minute.
Releasing Leathers, right-footed service of Leathers. John was there, the right place, right time. I have to wonder at what point does FC Dallas just look to lock the game down and try to get out of Empire Field with a draw. Ostley has other intentions. Well, here's a look at the play.
See two players obviously battling. Ostley extending both arms, pushing off.
Clearance by Blake Wagner. Ostley competing again. John winning out. He's done so frequently at the back today for FC Dallas.
Y saca ese remate que es desviado al corner por Ricketts. La primera chance importante del partido, clara de gol para el local.
Aquí va Eric Ávila, el cabezazo. Y Diego Balado me falla en los ojos por el cansancio. ¿Fue la mano de Ricketts o el palo del marco?
Fue la mano de Ricketts en el cabezazo de Jordan John.
Ahora es Omar González peleando, recuperando y retrasando para Beckham. Centro. Y es George John.
14 años de diferencia en cuanto a sus edades. 32 para Benítez y apenas 18 para Castillo.
A Diego Balado le pregunto, luego de esta, Ángel abriendo para Captain LD, Landon Timothy, encarado por Hugo y Emelo, servicio al corazón del área, rechazado por George John.
Para pasar al fútbol europeo, a donde quieren llegar todos.
¿Sabes que mucho se ha hablado acerca de esa juventud del fútbol estadounidense? Creo que en la labor de escauteo es de lo mejor que hay en el mundo. Servicio al área que está cortando George John.
Por eso quiere Bruce Arena utilizarlo como volante, no abierto por la derecha, porque él es el que puede llegar a dar el pase gol como aquí lo intentaba con el centro para la cabeza de Juan Pablo.
Quedó corto, se interpuso en la trayectoria George John.
This is a counterattack for Portland. Ball over the top. It's the pace of Perlaz in a foot race with John. Isolation for the Colombian. In the end, possession won by the third year center back, George John. There's a look at the runners for Dallas. Over the first man, it's George John!
Look at that ball set up right on top of the six-yard box by George John. Looked like he manhandled Bruner.
Not mistaken, it's the first goal that FC Dallas has scored on the free kick.